Order. Before I call the Prime Minister, I should like to inform the House that at 11 a.m. I shall invite colleagues to rise and observe 3 minutes silence in memory of those who lost their lives and the tragic events in the United States this week. Order. Statement, Prime Minister.
Mr. Speaker, sir, I'm grateful that you agreed to the recall of Parliament to debate the hideous and foul events that took place on Tuesday. I thought it particularly important in view of the fact that these attacks were not just attacks upon people and buildings, nor even merely upon the United States of America. These were attacks on the basic democratic values in which we all believe so passionately, and on the civilized world. It is therefore right that Parliament, the fount of our own democracy, makes its democratic voice heard. There will, of course, be different shades of opinion heard today, and again is as it should be. But let us unite in agreeing this. What happened in the United States on Tuesday was an act of wickedness for which there can be no justification.
arms training, or any similar weapons training, contact your nearest military officer immediately. Stay tuned to frequency 740 AM for further updates on this emergency.
Inflict such terror on the world, to take the lives of so many innocent and defenseless men, women, and children, can never, ever be justified. Let us unite, too, with the vast majority of decent people throughout the world in sending our condolences to the government and the people of America. They are our friends and allies, and we, the British, are a people that stand by their friends times of need, tragedy, and trial, and we do so without hesitation now. As we speak, the total death toll is still unclear, but it amounts, we know, to several thousands.
を強く支持し、最大限の支援と協力を惜しまない決意です。
Citizens of many countries around the world, including Britain, will have been caught up in this terror. I have just chaired an emergency meeting of the British Government Civil Contingencies Committee, and I would like to explain some of the measures that we have agreed to take here. There are a range of precautionary measures. We have stepped up security at airports to the highest levels. No flights will take off from the United Kingdom, for which we cannot apply the highest standards of security for air crew and passengers. Private flights have been stopped except where specifically authorised. Flight paths into London have been changed, so there will be no civil overflights of central London. Security has been increased across the full range of government buildings and military premises. The police across the whole of the UK are on full alert. All our defence facilities around the world have been moved to high alert to ensure the protection of British service personnel. Advice has been given to major financial and business institutions about appropriate security measures. A number of other security measures have been taken, and of course we are in close touch with US, European and other allies and are cooperating with them on issues of security. All relevant ministers remain in communication, and the committee, the Civil Contingencies Committee, will meet again tomorrow at 8 a.m. Obviously, some of these measures, not least the effect upon airports, will lead to some disruption. And I hope people understand that. But other than the specific measures we have taken, or that we have advised others to take, business and everyday life can continue as normal.
States.